everyone, this is Brandy, and she is a Schnoodle, which is a Schnauzer mixed with a Poodle. She's coming for grooming today. I'm just going to be giving her a haircut, cutting her nails, and doing her ears, and she's already had a bath from her owner, so I'm just going to take care of the other stuff, eh? She's a pretty relaxed girl, as you can see. Still not... Still would rather be somewhere else, but she tolerates me well. All right, so I'm going to be using a number 7 clipper blade, which is 3.2 millimeters. I use the Andes clipper blades. I know. I like to always start on this side. I guess just more my comfort zone. Okay. All right, ready? Good girl. That really nice thick fur. But not too curly of that poodle. There's a good girl. Hopefully I'll get her to stand up after. She's a bit nervous right now. But I always kind of like to work at their comfort level. Good girl. When I'm doing the side, I like to go with the body instead of up and down. Otherwise, it'll create some lines in her fur, especially when they have that thick fur. So I always go with the body, front to back. And you can go a little more of an angle when you get to the lower part. But that'll help prevent lines. And sometimes it may happen anyways. But that just helps prevent them. Good girl. This is starting to get warm, but better be safe than sorry, right? Mm-hmm. All right, we'll do this then. Come on. Okay. Okay. Switch out the blade again. You always want to make sure you're running a cool blade because otherwise it can burn their skin. That's a good girl. I'm going to add some oil. You can hear the difference possibly. Once I add it, kind of speeds up a little bit. Okay. Oh. Underneath, I am pulling it down before. That's how I kind of get underneath there from the side. And then I will stand her up too. Good girl. Okay. I'm going to switch the blade again. I'm going to do that bum area. I'm just going to use the same one because in that bum area, that fur actually goes in different directions. So it will, even though you're using the same blade, it'll actually look quite a bit shorter because the hair actually comes upward. You're actually cutting against the fur in some of this area. It comes in a few different directions, that's why you kind of got to go different directions with the blade. Good girl. And I'm going to use a number 10. Keep those clean, huh? Stay. Come on. There you go. There we go. Okay. Kind of gets the bulk of it off. So I'm going to do the paws and the nails now. And then I'll come back after, I'll give her a little blow dry, and I'll come back again with the same clipper. And then actually that'll catch a whole bunch more that got missed. And even though it looks like you got it, it'll poof it kind of up. So. Okay. Thank you, Brandy. Yeah, good girl. Brandy also comes in for regular nail trims as well, so her nails are looking really good. I just got to trim a little bit off of them. And also goes for regular walks as well, so that helps wear those down as well. Going. No. Okay, we want to do this one. Good girl. Later. Sometimes they just will. That now. Just gonna grab some paper towel. I'll be right back. Okay, here, let me get up. My big guard dog. Hey, quiet. That's enough. Okay, one more paw left. Hey, that's enough. Okay. See that she's got a thick tail here. It's kind of the poodle winded up there, so it's got a little bit of thickness to it, so I'm gonna thin it out. I can get through it here. Amazing how much comes over there. All right. Good girl. Okay, that's another good one done. Now, get the head and the face done. Right on the top of her muzzle there. And now let's do the other side. Even them out. Okay. End off anyway, so I'm not gonna comb that out to the end. Hope the same on both sides there, so layer that out. Out a little bit, so I'm not gonna trim it too much, just take it so it's not so blends a little bit more. Nipples. her ears longer too, so I'm just kind of gonna trim around them and pluck them and then comb them out and then just kind of blend them in, make sure they're all even. A little bit of curl on the top of her head here. That's a good girl. And a little bit of knots too. Okay, I'm just gonna paint the fitting shears to it. I always use my thumb as a guide to know where the actual ear is. You're using those thinning shears around here. They are sharp. There's a big clump. One more little knot at the back here. There we go. Yeah, very nice. Okay. Get a little bit of hair on it here. Not very much. It's okay. Just a little bit. Oh, hold on. Just a little bit of hair in there, but not very much. Okay. Yeah. There we go. Good girl. Anything else? With your hair. Alright, good girl. Okay, right, let's do this hair here. Here's a funny. All right, let's move this back so you can see what's going on. Okay, yeah, good girl. Alright, so I'm just gonna clean off what hair I can and give her a quick blow dry just to poof everything up, and then I'll use the number 7 again. Okay, then you'll be all done. Yeah. That's a good girl. Okay, so here's the low dry. Okay, good girl. See some hair. There's some new stuff. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna get the number 7 again.
Thank you.
Okay. We've got some curl in it. I'm just going to comb it just in case there's something in there. Oh, yeah, that's right behind there. Just the way it was sitting, it looked kind of bunchy. Curls a little bit there. All right. Okay, so thanks for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed her groom. Let me know what you think in the comments. And of course, if you haven't done so already, please subscribe. Thanks for watching. And we'll see you again. Okay. Hang on, Dad. I'm just going to give you one. It'll blow dry again. And a bird. Ready? Let's go. Come on. Good job. Okay. We'll see you again, guys.